We arrived on Orcas Island on May 22. One of the first goals was to get the boat in the water. After a week on Orcas Island, we needed to get Cody to the Seattle airport, so we took him in the boat. This trip is really a shakedown cruise for our Alaska trip, which is now less than 2 weeks away. We did all of the touristy kinds of things, but we all prefer the wilderness over the city. Right before our Alaska trip, Val's relatives, Bob and Carla Tinklenberg, came up and spent a few days with us. We showed them around some of our favorite spots in the islands. Cody got back from Summit Ministries camp on Saturday, June 13, and we set sail for Alaska on Tuesday the 16th. Generally, we'd cruise a couple of hours a day and spend a couple of hours hiking or exploring. Of course, every time we'd stop, we'd have to wet a line and see what we'd pull up. The further north we went, the more beautiful it got, and the fishing got better too. The whole trip we worked hard at catching shrimp and crab, but the best crabbing was right at home in our own backyard at Dolphin Cove. The fishing, on the other hand, got pretty phenomenal pretty quick.
You got a big one?
Yeah, it feels like a big one.
Ah! Oh, he's a fighter. Yep, he's running. Don't let him have any slack. What you got, buddy?
A halibut.
Should we weigh him?
Yeah.
Not a big one. We're going to let him go, but we'll weigh him. Hold him up proud, okay?
I said if it's over 15 pounds, you should keep him.
Pole stuck? Our first big fish of the year.
Oh, we don't know.
Oh, halibut!
Can you see it?
No, but I can't tell him anymore.
Here's Mom's.
The big one.
Well, we just landed another huge halibut. Even bigger than the first, but we don't know what it weighs yet. Then we lost a gaff trying to gaff it.
I had my wrist around the gaff hook and he was shaking so bad I thought my wrist was going to come off. So I let my hand out of the wrist and he flung the gaff hook out in the ocean.
No.
So now we got this, I don't know, 80 pound fish, no gaff hook.
And this halibut just took off to the bottom again, so we had to do the whole thing over again. This time without a gaff. So then Kent took the hook.
The boat hook.
The boat hook and a rope. Shoved it down his throat and ripped his guts out, kind of.
We fought him for all four of us for about 25 minutes.
Yeah, but we got him in the hatch.
Yep.
Weigh him and catch a can.
Okay, you want to lift the hatch real quick? There's still a lot of life in him, so here we go.
Lucky.
Look out, Lucky. Come here, girl. Okay, two of them in there.
Two of them in there, yeah.
The first fish turned out to be 41 pounds. The second, 109 pounds, is just over 5 feet tall and thicker than Connor. It took me over 4 hours of cleaning and vacuum packaging that fish before it was ready to bring to the processor who shipped him back to us in Sioux Falls. Each night we tried to find a pretty little cove to anchor in, and we did find some gorgeous spots. One of my favorites is Cascade Creek in Thomas Bay, where Val's dad, Daryl, and I spent a week up here a number of years ago and just had a great time. After pulling the porcupine quills out of Lucky and Tanner, we hiked up Cascade Creek. Our first iceberg of any significant size. The crystal clear, densely packed ice lasted a long time in our cooler. We are so grateful that we didn't ding a prop the whole time we were cruising through all that ice. 'Ford's Terror was another one of those beautiful anchorages where I could have spent a lot more time. Tanner is always on the prowl, and really hard to keep in the boat. That smoked salmon and cream cheese bagel sure looks good after a day of fun. Came as far as we could with the big boat. Now we're in the dinghy, trying to get to the face of the glacier.
Look at that flip! Oh!
Sitting in front of Sawyer Glacier watching it calve had to be one of the highlights for all of us. We spent a day in Juneau catching up on business before heading back out into the wilderness.
Where'd it go, Tanner? Where'd the fish go? Here we go. The official weight is 49 pounds. He's a nice fish.
Yes.
What do you think, Connor?
Awesome.
So, how was today?
Awesome, Tan.
What was awesome about it?
Seeing all the whales, catching the halibut.
Gee, wonder why I never catch any fish. Seems like all I do is bait hooks, clean fish, and pull hooks out of dog's ears. Prior to entering Glacier Bay, we had to attend a mandatory briefing and, of course, mandatory lunch.
There goes Cody.
I just had to have a little snoozer between all the action. We took the dinghy from the boat up to the face of the glacier and spent the afternoon climbing around. Cody said this was one of his favorite days. We spent 2 days anchored on the beach there in the upper left corner of your screen. Note the size of Connor compared to this glacier. The glaciers we visited were between 200 to 250 feet tall. Our week in Glacier Bay was spent cruising around looking at glaciers and exploring, and of course, fishing. Well, we made it. We dinghied up to McBride Glacier. We got here and a huge chunk just calved off, but obviously we missed it. Cody wants to take the dinghy into that cave.
Your idea.
Suicide!
Suicide.
That one's safe. That one's safe, he says.
Oh, there's little baseball sizes.
Baseball.
Hey, one baseball size, if it falls, that one's got a snake.
Yeah. How come it didn't fall?
It could,
I said.
Well, it's not.
Oh, there went another little piece.
I know, little pieces.
Oh. Look at that.
Oh.
Look at that.
This is a critical bird habitat, and the boys are trying to stone them. That was the last one. And that was the last one's eggs. One morning I was just sitting on the boat drinking my coffee when I noticed a bear swimming between the islands. So we jumped in the dinghy and just cruised beside him and watched him swim.
Thank you.
glasses, so he found a tennis partner.
Okay, ready? I scored.
I don't think so. I heard him return it.
Okay, well, he hit the net.
Out of bounds.
We just can't keep that Tanner out of the water. He loves to swim and fish. This is how we get groceries in Elfin Cove. One of the boaters in Elfin Cove told us about the White Sulphur Springs, and so we sailed for a couple of hours and found a nice little cove to anchor in, hiked through the forest until we found these beautiful springs with a Forest Service cabin. And we just spent the afternoon horsing around there.
Everybody, goodbye, goodbye! Ah!
You know how the saying goes, when you're not the lead dog, the view never changes. The same is true from the dinghy captain's seat. We had heard about this gold mine, and so we set off in the dinghy to try to find it, and sure enough, we did, and we spent the afternoon exploring it. We all love clam chowder, and so we decided to try to make some of our own. Connor would find them, and Tanner would dig them up. Of course, anything having to do with catching anything, and Tanner was all in. Our next stop was the cool little fishing village of Sitka, with a rich Russian heritage. We had a dock assignment next to a great Christian family. This is Ken and his son, who gave us a lot of great fishing tips. Being on a boat for 46 days does silly things to a person. For me, it was just allergies. Just kidding, this was staged, of course.
Okay, he's gonna run.
He did.
Go with you. There he is. I see he splash. Oh, Cody's got one too. You got him. Good deal. That's a nice fish, pal. Come on, Cody. Go get your
fish.
There's Cody's fish. Woo!
Cody, what'd you catch?
Big ol' fish. Oh, man. Cody, get your gloves on. You gotta get a picture with this guy.
Wow, that one's a big one.
Beautiful, beautiful, though I am lost for more. cold tears. Who I would be put out to let things go. And I just want to wait on you, my God. But I just want to dwell on who you are. Beautiful, beautiful, oh, I am lost for more to say. Beautiful.
But he grew a bit of a tail. Just off of
Sea Otter Cove.
In Sea Otter Cove, about 220 feet of water, and I just caught this 73 pounder.
Yay!
Yay! More fish.
Belle and I took a couple of hours and hiked up to this alpine lake where I found a Forest Service canoe and caught this 27-inch rainbow trout. Beautiful fish. We cooked them up on an open fire for lunch. Cody went fishing and in about a half an hour caught these beautiful red snapper. Punchbowl Cove in the beautiful Misty Fjords National Monument was one of our most favorite spots. Let's Go Cliff Jumping.
Do it.
Good boy, Tanner.
Is that your stick? Go get it.
We never did find a cliff that Tanner wouldn't jump from. This particular one was 22 feet.
Well, we just got to Hack Eye Beach. We're anchored on the other side of the little spit and walked about a quarter of a mile to this beautiful beach. Nice and sunny and warm. Connor's actually swimming in that water. Wow. Beautiful day. Got our limit of coho salmon in about 2 hours this afternoon. Just been a fun day again.
We blew an outdrive in Port Hardy. Connor made the most of it, was catching fish right off the dock. We were only down about a day and a half before we were sailing again. There goes Tanner, showing off again. 47 days later, we're back at Dolphin Cove. We put on 3,230 miles and burned 1,700 gallons of diesel. Sorry, Mr. Gore. The day we got back to Dolphin Cove, Cody's best friend, Andre, came out to visit, and so did John and Angie Glasser. All good things must come to an end. Andre flew home, we packed up, and hit the road. The rest of these pictures are all taken in the San Juan Islands by our friends who live there.
Things of earth will grow.
Two.